I am Michelle McPherson, and this is The Michelle McPherson Show, the only internet marketing podcast dedicated to answering your burning business questions. Find us and submit your own questions at fromideatoempire.com. And now for today's episode. These stats are why you should be using lead boxes from lead pages. And what we're seeing here are opt-in rates from 73% all the way up to 79%. Lead boxes are these little opt-in pop-ups, and they appear when you click a link in like a blog post or something. You can see an example of them at michellemcpherson.com. One post that has them is titled The Simple Automated Social Media Blueprint for a Local Business. And if you head on over to the blog post associated with this podcast, of course, there will be a link to that. So when you are interacting with a lead box, a reader will see and click the download PDF button within an article on my blog. That's how I use it. But it can be any link within a post or an article on any site, works on other people's sites. One of the examples that Clay Collins, the owner of Lead Pages, gives is that if you were to do a guest post on someone's site in your little about the author section, you could put a link to a lead box and then it would work from there. Basically, any link can be turned into a lead box. And on my site, I offer people the ability to download the post as a PDF. So once they click that link, they see the actual lead box, which is like a standard kind of hover pop-up kind of thing. And it asks for their email address. And once they enter that, of course, they'd be sent the download. So there's two very interesting things about this method overall of using lead boxes. And then, of course, those super high opt-in rates, those stats that we're seeing for this. First thing, there's no magic lead magnet. There's no secret in the download itself. Of course, you can do that if you have some really exceptional lead magnets that you would like to give to your subscribers. But in this case, and what I think is important about this example, is that what people are getting is a PDF download of the post that they are already reading. It is a PDF download of the post on the page that they are already on. And they're completely aware of that. They could, of course, just read the blog post, but people are still kind of attached to downloading things, printing them, and in a little emotional way, sort of owning the content and knowing that it will always be there for them. It makes them feel like it's safe and secure. So downloading a PDF of the content that they've found valuable allows them to have that emotional ownage of the content. And a hat tip to James Schramko for the idea to use a PDF transcript of the blog post as the downloadable. That was his idea that he does over at superfastbusiness.com, and I've implemented it on my site as well after seeing the results that he was getting. The point here is that you don't need to create a crazy incentive for your readers to opt in. If your content is good, they will, even when the information that they're opting in for is already available to them. Secondly, the opt-in rates that we're seeing are really high with lead boxes. Getting opt-in rates like 79%, 73% without creating any additional content, without creating new PDFs or videos or secret giveaways, that's incredible. Those are really, really great rates. Lead Pages wrote that they see a relative increase in opt-in conversions of about 30% by using a two-step opt-in process over a one-step opt-in process. A two-step process is like a lead box where you click a link, that's step one, and then step two is you fill out the form. A one-step process is just when the form is in line on the actual page. I didn't believe Lead Pages until I tried it myself and was able to see that, yeah, the opt-in rates are a lot higher for these two-step processes than for the one-step process. The emotional commitment that the user experiences of proceeding through a two-step form makes a big difference in those end results. Now, we're transitioning all of our properties over to use lead boxes within our blog posts, and I wanted to share these stats with you so that you see the value of it as well in case it is something that you can implement on your site and in your business to grow your email list. This is Michelle McPherson with The Michelle McPherson Show, and if you've got any questions about email marketing, lead boxes, or lead pages for that matter, head on over to michellemcpherson.com and hit the Ask Anything button. I'll be happy to answer your questions. All right, thanks so much. Bye-bye.